What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. This is gonna be a bit of a different kind of vlog here. So today's Friday, May 17th, and as some of you may know, Terri and I are getting married on the 18th, which is tomorrow. So right now we're just kind of getting everything ready. Here's how this is gonna go down. So tonight we will go our separate ways. I'm going with my groomsmen. We're going up to a cabin near the wedding venue. Terri and her bridesmaids are going to a cabin near the wedding venue separately. And I am going to be using this camera, and she is going to be using another camera of mine. And we're just going to kind of bounce back and forth between hers and my night. So it's going to be awesome. We're going to record all the way into the wedding day. This ought to be fun. I'm really excited. Hopefully you guys are too. Tomorrow is a big day, big day. There's going to be a lot going on. So I'm gonna try and get all of that on camera. We are currently standing in front of the drift car. I'm about to load it up on the trailer as it will be used as a prop as soon as you walk into the wedding venue. And then when we leave tomorrow night, we will probably leave in it and it may get a little smoky.
We've made it. It is officially wedding weekend. It is Friday at, I don't know what time it is, 10 in the morning.
10:01.
10:01. It's me and Tree. We are at the nail salon. All the other girls are gonna meet us and my mom and the lady that's doing our makeup, Miss Maggie, for the wedding. We're meeting here. We're gonna get manis and pedis and have some mimosas and start this wedding weekend off right.
Easily the hardest decision that a girl has to make is what color do we want on our nails. So many choices. So now we're gonna break bread at Olive Garden. Oh,
you're licking your lips.
That is magnificent. The amount of things that go into making us beautiful is outrageous. This is the painting bed I'm about to get in. So, looks like a spaceship.
Ta-da! Now she's all loaded. Now it's time to go in, make sure we have everything else, pack a bag, and we're off. Alright guys, so we made it up here to Townsend where our cabin is for the weekend, and because of the grade of the driveway, I chose not to take the truck up and risk going off the side of a mountain. So we have it parked down here in the bottom of this whole mountain, guarded by a shack over there. Hopefully nobody steals our car or our truck. And I got two groomsmen here. We got Zack and Jacob. We're gonna head up to the cabin and have a good night. We'll show you guys the cabin when we get there.
Right.
Been a while, huh?
Now get the speed going here. All right, here we go.
Watch out for those rocks.
Yeah! Yeah! Oh, there's a bump!
Oh! We got a bump coming up!
Uh-oh!
5, 3, 1! Bigger bump!
Alright! 3, 2, 1. Blast off.
Barely moved. Oh, Josh, he's gone! Come on!
That was a severe amount of g-forces, guys. We just looked.
So after 75 hours of last minute wedding tasks, we are leaving our house for the third time today. I forgot my wedding shoes. Tyler forgot his tux and Trent's tux. So
Luckily, we were here when he realized that he had done that. So we are officially leaving the house. It is wedding time. This is Tara.
7:07.
It's 7:07. This time, 7:07 tomorrow, we will be married. So we will hopefully not have any more hiccups because my patience is thin at its best. So we're running on zero. My headache is on 700. And I've got a cabin full of bridesmaids waiting for me to feed them. So stay tuned. Pray for me, y'all. Just pray for me.
Holy Bible.
We made it up the actual mountain. I should have recorded that part because the trek up here was fierce. It was gravel and scary. But we made it. And so we're going to go in and investigate. We got the bow pack family thing.
All right. So we're at the cabin. Show you guys living room, the TV, porch that we won't go on because there's bears out there. One nice big bedroom here with a jacuzzi tub. Go up the stairs here. Got another big bedroom up here, and then great view out here. We'll walk out here. So nice out there. We're getting married like somewhere over in here, I believe, if my geography is correct.
A bride feast.
Seven dollhouse.
A bride feast.
That's dollhouse.
Amber made it.
I did. I've never.
This is our cabin.
It's real cute. Oh, your cabin. Can take a picture of it.
The winner's cake.
Okay, so every time that we gather,
give me a napkin. Can you turn its face a little bit?
Wait, do you want me to hold it while you kiss it?
Okay.
I don't want it.
Hello.
Hi, Tyler Berry Drifting Face. Oh, he made a little sound.
No, that was quickly, you guys.
Swiftly, even.
Oh, God. Erica has just informed me that it is T minus 30 minutes until wedding day. So far tonight we have crafted window picture frames. They're gonna hang on both sides of the entrance to the reception. There's like a pavilion and like barn style doors there that will be really, really cute. So those will go on there. We have dresses, we have our button downs. We have our big, huge I Said Yes bag of things that go to the venue tomorrow. One of everything is in there. And we're gonna steam these and probably go to bed.
Probably.
Sounds like a good idea because we're almost at wedding day. So no pressure, it's fine. It's wedding day! So we just got out of the shower. We're gonna go to the venue because we're late per usual and get our hair and makeup done. We've already cried. Personally, we've already cried. So we're done with that now and we're moving on. So here we go.
What up, guys? We're all loaded up. Got all the groomsmen in here. Jacob, Zack, Corey, James, and Trent are all over there. We're gonna head down to the bottom of the hill, get my truck, and then we're gonna head to the venue, start getting ready, and live it up. Today's gonna be a good day. Nice outside, we're gonna sweat to death, but it's gonna be fun.
Okay, so we're at the venue. We've started the process.
This is
Step one.
Step one, D-bag. We're here, guys. We've almost made it.
Oh, you're beautiful.
Teamwork makes the dream work, you guys.
Do you love it? What do you say?
You are so beautiful, Sylvia. Do you feel like a princess? Bride.
White.
Ooh, girl. They are white. You look pretty fantastic.
I know.
She said, I know.
So they brought the flowers in. And they're stunning, and I cried. So now we are about to start pictures of getting ready.
Hey, Carl, are you good on the turbo?
Hey!
Yeah, okay. How you doing? Well, that's gonna keep happening all day.
Guys, I'm looking fly.
Okay, very good. Oh. Drop it off. Walk back.
Tyler Berry. It's me, your brother-in-law. I stole your camera so that I could share with your vloggers my advice. You're marrying my sister, and it's very important to me that she be treated like a queen, because she just requires that. She's had some hard luck, man. She's been through a lot, but you were the guy that she chose to heal that. I just pray, man, for you guys that through the hard times, man, because it gets rough sometimes. I've been married 6 years now. It's the best decision I ever made. But it does get hard, man. It gets hard. And I just pray that you guys strengthen your relationship enough so that when those hard times come, man, it's like no problem. So I just want you guys to know that I love you both almost equally, but not quite. But I have a good time with you, man, and I'm glad that you're gonna be in the family. I'm glad that our families mesh well together, and dude, I'm excited that I have a new brother. Love you, man. Peace.
Beautiful.
She has been dying to see you.
I'm sorry.
Come
on in.
You
can come see me. Look at your dress. I love it. You look like a princess. Yeah. I love it.
Look at you.
What about my sparkly shoes, right?
All right, so when we get out here, you're going to stop just a little bit beforehand, right? Okay.
No, she's already starting.
Start there. Part.
You want it this way now or no?
That's
what's going on.
I'm nervous.
I'm gonna help you out with the nerves. What are you gonna do? Come to me?
No, I don't
want to touch you. Yeah. That's for when I have to get married. Then he gets the
pot. I'll do that. No, when
I'm doing him a favor.
Oh, yeah, he's trying to sell me.
Yeah, he said there's no refunds.
No refunds, no returns.
So we are in full on wedding. And we just were outside in the 90 degree heat for like 20 or 30 minutes taking pictures. So we're in here trying to.
She needs a donut.
We had a pretzel and an emergency cheese ball. So we are inside now. We're being quarantined because the guys are outside taking pictures. So we are glad about that because it is very, very hot out there. So we are gonna hang out here and then we're gonna get this party started because it's like 4:15 and the wedding starts at 5.
Let's just start with this.
God, we come before you right now, and we ask you to bless this ceremony. God, with your presence, Father, Lord, that God, it will be blessed with the love that these two share for each other, the Heavenly Father, Lord, and God, that this day, God, will be the best day of the rest days of their life. God, and each day to follow will just follow suit and build upon what they're doing today. God, I thank you for bringing them to this place. I thank you for putting them together, God. I thank you, God, that they have allowed you to be the centerpiece and the foundation in which they built their relationship upon. And God, I just want to give you honor and glory and praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Reasons why you fell in love with Tyler. And go.
He is kind. He is smart. And he is
important. I knew you were going to say that.
Because he is kind and he is funny and he is passionate about all of the things that he does, including, I'm not limited to, playing drums at church on Sunday morning and everything else that he does.
But bro, don't I just fixed it.
Yeah, it's fine. We're good.
So no more.
There's like 1,000 reasons, but there's 3 fast ones for you.
It's like 5:15. I'm sure we're supposed to go out there.
We're all
supposed to
be out there.
Yeah, my thing says from what she's on time, I guess I have to be, huh?
Yeah.
Are you feeling nervous?
Face and beat.
Yeah.
Let's go 30.
Don't get going.
Go 30.
They a couple of circles around the whole crowd just running.
Yeah.
And make noises. Make sound effects.
Tyler, go take your wheel out of your car. look at his face.
No, look at that.
Process.
That's the first note.
Oh, man.
No way.
What?
No way.
What?
It's raining.
Oh,
I was worried that was about to happen.
Now it'd be humid.
Dude.
No.
Hey, it's good.
Terry got me toe up.
My daughter is
Let's say the court.
Hey, don't even talk about it.
If you're down with these.
Say we just give us a little Passover.
It'll pass over. Saith the Lord.
Hey, your windows are out. There's like no chance of rain right now. So
yeah.
It ought to be gone.
Clearly.
Zero.
Oh my gosh. This is crazy.
And it's coming down.
Dude, it is coming down.
I can't focus enough.
God just had to pull you around.
Well, there's a pocket right there.
I'm not going to put it in that pocket because I already tried it.
That's
once.
Pretty packed
it up and I have to like.
Okay. Just put it in your hand. You're going to be standing there like this.
I got to take the rose up there first.
Yeah, that's fine.
After that, you can put them in your hand.
Yeah, when you go stand up there, just put
you
it in your hand.
You got to prepare, bro.
I'm trying, bro.
Yeah.
You got to think ahead.
I'm trying with your hand.
Okay.
So once I get up there with you, just.
Yeah, you can't tell.
Put it in your hand and hold it. Just don't forget
and
it's
once
in
I
there,
sneeze.
Yeah, relax your hand.
You're taking advice from him like he knows what he's doing.
You've
done this before?
Never. So, Tyler, it's actually good luck when it rains on your wedding day.
Is it really?
It is. That's a real telltale.
I'm pretty sure. Jacob has this way of making you think positive at every situation.
Every single
one. If it wasn't raining, you'd be like, dude, you know it's such good luck when it doesn't rain on your wedding day?
Yeah. That's not true.
Hey, good news. I can see tons of sun over there, and the clouds are almost gone.
Show us the light, preacher. Show us the light.
You can see over there. There's tons of light.
What is that song about the light?
I saw the light. I mean, I saw
not country.
Sorry.
Not Baptist.
So happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord. I saw the light. No.
Your car.
Hurry up, it's a cool fall.
Like
oh, I can't zoom in that far.
Dyalla
Berry!
I did it!
I thought somebody was dying, you guys.
Come on, dude! We got emergency.
It was a photo emergency. That was a cool fog. Good call, photo man. Zack Hawkins photography, everybody.
We're on a rain delay. It was the prettiest day of the year 20 minutes ago.
Now.
And now it's pouring. Everything's soaked. Guests, chairs, my programs that I paid $200 for yesterday.
Cheese balls.
No, the cheese balls were saved. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. So now we wait until everything is dry, and then we can walk down the aisle. I'm fine. It's fine. We're all fine. Everything's fine.
Well, I'm too far up.
Green. What happened? Where did this come from?
Yeah, there it is.
It was not on the radar all day. I think it got too hot.
Where's it at?
Which way is it going? It's just right on the edge of
it.
That's
it right there.
Oh, baby.
Woo!
Still drying out from the first time.
It's definitely coming off a little bit.
Tara, is she toe up?
A little bit. She's okay.
Oh!
Oh.
That is a personality picture of the two of you if I've ever seen one.
Let's see. Let me see. Huh? I'm in.
Nothing.
I'm in.
She said nothing. She said nothing.
What did that say?
I don't know.
This seems sketchy.
Did that say what I think that it said?
Nope. Didn't say anything.
Huh?
I think that text message said that it's hailing.
No, it said come hail or high water.
See, Lord Whelan and the creek don't rise. Hallelujah. Hail or high water, Lord Whelan.
I don't like that face.
No, it's good. All is well. I made her smile. She's good. She's not even worried about the hail.
Okay, what about the rain?
Well, here's the thing. You tell her that it's hailing, so whenever she finds out it's only raining, she's like, oh, okay, that's not so bad. Oh, no. And everyone.
Just listen.
Ain't going nowhere.
Okay.
You know God got you, right?
Yeah.
All right, it's all good. It's all good.
One minute,
okay.
Just one time.
Tell me about those potatoes.
For the bomb duty, thank you.
Tell me about them. Are they fire?
Yeah. It's amazing.
I hope it wasn't cold by the time they got down here. Thank you. Is that for a groomsman or a bridesmaid?
They can have the it.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
You're welcome. Can you get that?
I'd be glad.
Okay, just don't look in. Don't look in.
I'm gonna get the door. I'm not looking. Oh, you got it.
There you go. Cheers.
Two more coming in.
Filled
hey,
up.
Who
or?
Else needs one?
Look at this man. Oh,
this is a tray they've made from my Bible verse down the aisle.
Oh my goodness.
Fred, that's a first.
Look at this.
VIP.
Are you ready?
Okay, VIP please know tray. That this tray. This tray is from the.
Yep,
the
thing box. Outside the box.
I don't really want to talk about what's going on right now, but I'm just going to show you guys.
We're just eating.
It's good.
It's delicious. Totally worth it. caterer. Yeah, should we curtsy for the caterers?
We had to let our guests eat. So I still haven't seen my groom. And we're That's waiting until
Look
it is
at
time.
This, Terri, video this.
Okay, please know that this tray is from the Bible verse that was down the aisle. They have created the tray with my scripture. This is a first. I was
that is awesome.
I love it.
I'm about to start drinking. You might even go. I don't even drink.
That's some wine right there.
Head to the bar.
Oh, God. Hey.
I have no idea.
Is there a lot
There's
of people?
A lot of people out there.
I haven't even seen everybody. I don't know who else here, but
there's a lot of people there.
From the parking lot, it didn't look like it was.
I want to see our sea race car.
What time is it, y'all?
It's game time!
We're getting married, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh. Finally! Okay, here we go, everybody. Are the girls all here?
Yep.
Yes. Okay, great.
They're all here.
First of all, thank you for your patience today. You guys have been great. This has been crazy, but it's held up and everything's going to be just like it was. And everybody stay and we'll go straight into the dancing and have a good time, okay?
Devil could never be long enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way.
At this point, on behalf of the bride and groom, I want to ask everyone if they would please put their cell phones on silent, put them away. Ask everybody if they would please stand.
Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my heart.
Friends, we're here today in the presence of God to unite Tyler and Terri in marriage. The Bible teaches that marriage is a permanent relationship with one man, one woman, freely and totally committed to each other as companions for life. Our Lord declared that man should leave his father and mother and unite with his wife and build in a home, and the two shall become one flesh. Who gives this bride to be with?
Her mother, amen.
You may be seated. The home was built upon love, which virtue is best portrayed in the 13th chapter of 1 Corinthians, Paul's letter. He said, love is patient and kind. It's not jealous or boastful. It's not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrong, but rejoices in right. Love bears all things. Love believes all things. And love hopes in all things. Love endures all things, and love never ends. Tyler, will you take Terri to be your wife? And you, will you commit yourself to her happiness and her self-fulfillment as a person and her usefulness in God's kingdom? And will you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve her in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to her so long as you both shall live? And Terri, do you take Tyler to be your husband? And will you also commit yourself to his happiness and his self-fulfillment as a person and to his usefulness in God's kingdom? Do you promise to love, honor, and trust him, serve him in sickness and health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to him so long as you both shall live? So when giving her the ring, you're telling your partner, from this day forward, you can count on me. I'm always going to be there, come hell or high water, come thunder and lightning, come rough waves that will roll on the sea. I'm right there by your side. And when you can't go, I'll carry you. And when you feel like falling behind, I'll lead you. So Tyler, if you would take Terri, and if you would place the ring on her finger, and Tyler, repeat after me. With this ring, I pledge my life and love to you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Repeat after me. Tyler, with this ring, I pledge my life and my love to you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. By the power invested in me, by our Heavenly Father, God, it is my privilege and my honor to pronounce you husband and wife.
Amen.
Woo!
Tyler and Terri, rather than do the unity candles and the sand and all that, they've got another little thing that they're going to do symbolizing their marriage to each other and the binding of the two of them and our Father.
Do it.
We didn't practice
binding. I know. It's fine. I'll teach you. You got this.
In the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 4, God's word read like this. Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow. But woe unto him that is alone when he falleth, for he has no one to lift him up. And again, if two lie together, they have heat. But how can one warm alone? And if one prevail against him, two shall be able to withstand him, but a threefold cord is not quickly broken.
Oh, we just did that one.
So they are braiding together the rope to make it not one, not two, but three. Thus uniting the three most important aspects of the wedding today. That's God the Father and his deity, the husband and his purity and sanctification by God the Father, and the bride and her sanctification through the forgiveness of the Father. And thus they have come today before you and before, most importantly, God, and they have bound those three important institutions. And no longer are they two, no longer is it three, but now as they get ready to go from here, they leave one unity, one unit in God. If you all will stand. Again, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Tyler and Terri. Yeah.
White dress, that calls a baby. It's a good day for marrying you.
was with that GoPro. This
whenever he said
y'all
were
gonna get to kiss up there. No, I was like, you better kiss that man.
Yeah, at my wedding, if you're over 30, you can't come.
Right.
You're not invited.
But we might all be over 30, so.
Oh my god.
Man. Apply ice to burned area.
And this is Tyler.
A little bit like this.
Wandering the city street, another face in the crowd, head looking down, lost in the sound of a hundred other things. Empty pockets and a roulette, always landing on a lost bed. And just live for a spin and hope for the win. Go all in just to lose again.
I don't think that there's ever been a better looking groom or a more beautiful bride, so can we please give him another hand? So Tyler, I'm extremely blessed to call you my best friend. One of the many things you've taught me in life, and you've taught me a lot of things, but there's some lessons that stick out the most to me. Number one, if anybody ever knows you, knows this, that you work hard at every single thing you do. And number two is that you love every single person around you. And you always have a smile on your face. These are the characteristics that define you. And Terri, just as I know that Tyler's going to love you with everything he has in him, I know that you're going to do the very same, because you love every single person that you know, whether it's the first time you meet them, and you love them with the love of Christ, and it's never ending, and it's amazing. I have to say, growing up next to someone allows you to experience all of their adventures with them. I've been here with Tyler through all the good and the bad. The good usually consisted of us sharing a DiGiorno pizza together, watching Walk the Line for the 100th time with our dad. And the bad usually consisted of us arguing over who was going to clean up the pizza pan afterwards.
And she is just the most precious and loving person, as all of you here know. As far as Tyler goes, the first time that I met him, I will say, I did not give him a fair shot. I have loved Terri for a very long time, and I have taken it upon myself, the mama in me, to kind of guard her heart in a lot of ways. And she was head over heels the second that she met this morning. I was like, there ain't no way. There ain't no way he is as good as you're saying. And after I met him, I was like, there you are again, judging. I did the same thing with Terri, and Tyler has been nothing but perfect for her, and I thank God every day for him. You're both so precious to me, and if you just open your heart to things and you trust God's timing, that the right people are going to come into your life, and that absolutely is a testimony of them. So I love you both very much, and Terri and Tyler.
people. I always have a lot to say. I don't want everyone to hear. Yeah. Our song said it best. I loved her first. As always, and always will be, my little girl. And no matter how old you get, you still will be my baby girl. I told Tyler that. He told me last week. Gosh, man, I'm really getting nervous. There's nothing to be nervous about. Well, then I'm going to cry. It don't matter. Everybody out there is going to see you cry. They don't know if you're crying because you love her. They don't know if you're crying because of the money that you spend on the story. They don't know why you're crying. Don't worry about it. I said, but one thing is for sure, I want you to know right now, it's not Walmart. You're not getting a receipt. There is no refund. You're not going to buy it. I cut up and joke with him all the time. Gary said, Tyler, you're just going to have to learn my dad. You're going to have to learn my dad. He don't catch on as quick as most people that I've been around. But I love him to death. He's been really good. Been really good for her. And I think she's good for him. And this commitment proved that. Well, I appreciate everybody that came and like Kara said, weathered the storm. Thank you all.
I can already tell you guys are meant for each other because you're both quirky, you're both a little goofy. Just watching the first dance out here, I can tell you guys have a lot of fun together. Which are obviously meant to be because every single person here loves you and supports you guys together. So may you always multiply and never divide. And with that note, we're gonna cut some cake. Woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, Mr. and Mrs. Tyler Berry Drifting